He was all excited about starting a church and everything. But anyway, today I'm going to preach about how bright is your light.
Come on.
In pre-service prayer this morning, as Katie and I and Mickey began to pray, we was praying up here, and I heard the words, "The light is breaking through." And it was "The light is breaking through" for BWC, for me personally. It was for me personally, "The light is breaking through." The light is breaking through for BWC, and it's breaking through for each individual one here. And what the Lord showed me was, each individual one of us represents a house. Mm-hmm. You know, we're the house of, we are the house of the Lord. This is where the Lord dwells, in us.
Yeah.
I mean, yes, this, we call the building the house of the Lord, and it is, but we are actually the house of the Lord. He dwells in houses not built by man.
Yeah.
He built.
Yeah.
Amen? He builds his house. And the gates of hell won't prevail against it.
That's right.
But anyway, what I seen was these buildings, and these buildings were dark inside. And we all have dark things inside us. We have darknesses hidden down in us. A lot of us are walking around and there's no light coming in. You know, some of us have never had the light of Jesus in us. Till you get saved, you don't have the light of Jesus in you. But even when you got the light of Jesus in you, sometimes it's been covered over so much and it's had stuff come in and covered up that light. And the light of Jesus can't get in to those dark areas. But he said the light is breaking through. And what I seen was like, what I seen was parts of a roof being pulled off and the sunlight coming in.
Praise God.
Shining into those dark areas. And when the light, you got a dark area, a dark house, and you let the light come in. When the light come in, the roof is scrambled.
Yeah.
The light of Jesus comes in, the demons going to scatter.
Amen.
Yeah.
And the light comes in, and man, you see the dirty areas, you go to cleaning them up.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like I told Katie and Mickey. You ladies can relate to this more, as you got big old heavy curtains closed in, you know, and you move in this room and it's all dark and the curtains is all closed in. You know, and I've seen on TV how these women will come in and they'll rip them curtains back, you know, and let the sunlight come in. It lights up the whole room, you know.
Yeah.
Jesus is the light.
Yes.
And the light comes in. And it reveals all the sin. It reveals everything. And what is revealed can be healed.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
When you let the light of Jesus come in, when that light begins to break through, those dark areas can be shown. And can be revealed, and that's what I got this morning. Was the light is breaking through on each individual one of us here, and there's dark areas in our life, but that light gonna come in as long as we let it be coming in. Let the cracks move, and let the light come in. Open them curtains and let the light in, and it'll reveal those dark areas in our life. And they can be healed.
Amen.
And we can be set free.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Anyway, the title of my message this morning is, "How Bright Is Your Light?" How bright is your light? See, I'm not talking about the light that's breaking in. Now I'm talking about the light that you have, that you should be shining. How many of you ever heard the song, and I know you have, this... Everybody sing.
This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. It'll shine all over the world tonight. I'm going to let it shine. Shine all over the world tonight. I'm going to let it shine, let it shine. shine, let it shine, let it shine. And I ain't gonna let old Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Well, I ain't gonna let old Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
You know, we can sing that. I remember singing that song in Bible school when I was a little fella, probably our age. You know, we would sing that song. I always liked singing it, and I always thought it was a kid song, you know, but I think it's an adult song too, you know. Mm-hmm. We just go to sing. But we need to, something happened to me this week that I tell you, we need to get to where our light shines out there.
Yeah.
And not just here.
Amen.
We need to shine our light out there. Some of us say, oh, I let my light shine. I would say that. I would say, oh, I let my light shine. I've said it for years. I've said it for years. And there was a certain amount of light that I would let shine. But I'm going to tell you, and I'm just being honest with you this morning, my light was a whole lot brighter here than it was out there, and that should not be.
Amen.
That should not be. If you're a spotlight here, you should be a spotlight out there.
Amen.
Amen.
But a lot of us are spotlights here, and we're candles out there.
Come on.
Amen.
I'm just being purely honest with you this morning. Oh, we'll come in here. We'll hoop and hop, holler and shout and kick and stomp, praise the Lord, and, you know, act so holy and righteous. But we are the light of the world.
Yeah, that's right.
Turn them back in your books to in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 5. Are you a bright light or are you a dim light? Matthew chapter 5. Now I'm actually going to start off talking about salt, because this scripture starts out with salt, salt and light. Says, you are the salt of the earth. But if salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Father, we thank you this morning for your word, Father. I thank you that you open the ears of the church this morning to hear what the Spirit would say to the church. And I ask for your anointing to just flow through me and through, and your anointing to be upon this body of Christ here this morning to receive it. In Jesus' name, amen. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty? You know, I wrote this note down. If we lose our saltiness, we are just blending in. You think about it. If you're pouring salt, if you're trying to salt some type of food or something to change the flavor of it, but it's no longer salty, and you're putting it in there and you're stirring it, it's just blending.
Yeah.
It's just blending in, and it's just not changing nothing.
Yeah.
Do you get the picture?
Yeah, it's good.
That's what that's talking about. If you've lost your saltiness, and when we go out into the world, that's where we need to be salt. Mm-hmm. And if we're not salty, if we're not being salty, we're just blending in. Yeah.
Amen.
We're just blending in. I'm tired of blending in. I want to be different.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Amen.
I was praying day before yesterday. I want to be a Christian on Monday, and yeah, not just on Sunday.
Amen. Yeah.
You know, when you say, "Well, brother, you're the pastor of this church," that's right. But I'm also out in the world on Monday through Saturday. I'm out in the world. And oh yeah, I'm the pastor of this church. But before I'm the pastor of this church, I'm a child of the living God, the Most High God.
Yeah.
That He wants me to let His light shine out of me, out there.
Yeah.
Yes, I lead this church. I'm the pastor of this church. But out there is where I need to make a difference.
Amen.
Out there is where we all need to make a difference.
Yeah.
Out there is where we need to be salt.
Yeah.
Out there is where we need to be changing the flavor of things.
Amen.
Yeah.
The church, we're not doing it.
Come on.
The church of today has lost its saltiness. I'm not talking about BWC, I'm talking about the whole church. The whole body of Christ in general has lost its saltiness. They're blending more and more. It's not only out there, they're not only blending out there, they're blending in here now. Don't want to offend nobody. Don't want to say nothing that might be a little salty to somebody.
Come on.
Yeah.
You might run them off. Let's don't talk like that. Let's don't preach that kind of stuff. That's too salty. Tone the salt down a little bit. That's what's going on today.
That's why the nation has gone downhill.
That's exactly right, Mr. Jim. The church in America has lost its saltiness. The church in America has become a blend. You can't even tell whether it's salt in it or not. Just being honest. Telling you the truth. You know, this here ministering to me, I mean, there was something happened to me this week, and I'm gonna cover it in a little while because of the way I'm going to preach it. It made me stand up and say, hey, you need to do something. You need to change the way you live.
Come on.
I got to change some things. We should be thermostats and not thermometers.
Yeah.
You see that thermostat up there says 73 degrees. That means that it wants that air conditioner to blow until it gets 73 degrees in here. There, it's probably got a thermometer on it that when it says it gets 73, then it can shut off. A thermometer, though, blends to the temperature around it, rises or lowers to that temperature. A thermostat says, I want you at 73, get there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not changing.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We should be thermostats.
Yeah.
Too many of us are thermometers. I'm tired of being a thermometer.
Amen.
Talking to me. Talking about being in the workplace. I'm not talking about being here. I'm talking about being in the world.
Yeah.
Oh, we can come in here. You know, and we can raise our hands. And we can do jumping jacks. You know. And we can do all kinds of things in here. And I'm not saying you got to go out in the world and do jumping jacks and act crazy. No, you know, you do whatever the Lord moves on your heart to do, but be the person out there that you are in here.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
There should be no difference.
Amen.
I've always felt like, you know, for years I've always felt like, well, I don't think there's any difference in me out there than he is in here, but there has been. I mean, everybody recognized me as a Christian out there to a certain point. But I'm telling you, it's coming time whenever the sheep and the goats have got to be separated.
Amen.
And I don't want to have no goat hair showing on me.
Amen.
I want to look like a sheep, smell like a sheep, blake like a sheep, run like a sheep. I want him to know that's one of my sheep.
Amen.
Don't cull him. Bring him into the herd. Well, if you want him to know that, you better start acting like him.
Come on. Yeah.
Because if you're acting like a goat, then bless God, you're going to be culled into the goat herd. You might have a little bit of wool on you mixed in, but there can't be no mixture.
That's right.
It ain't going to happen. Because it's coming back for a spotless bride.
Yes.
It's coming back for a spotless lady. His grace is sufficient for us. But what I'm telling you is, it's time that the church get real.
Yeah.
It's time that the church start acting the same way out there as they do inside. But see, instead, the church is acting the same way here as they act out there. Why they're blending. You know, I've seen it. I've seen it in lots of churches. I've seen that out there coming into the church instead of the church going out there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's nothing wrong with a lot of the things some of the churches do, and I'm not going to point none of them out. But they, some things have no place in the church.
Amen.
But they're all over the church nowadays. They want to make it to where people come in. They'll be comfortable there. They'll feel at home. I don't care if this church don't never grow to no bigger than enough to what we have here. I don't care. I'm going to preach the Word of God.
Amen.
And when I stand before Him, I'm going to hear him say, "Well done, son. You didn't blend."
Amen.
Well done, son. You preached it. You gave it to them. You didn't try to entice them with all kinds of things. You gave them the Word of God. The Word of God says, unless the Lord builds a house, they labor in vain. I refuse to labor in vain.
Amen.
If he wants me to have 5,000, fine. If he wants me to have 5, fine.
Amen.
It ain't about numbers. It's about
growth.
It's about growth. It's about
discipling.
Huh?
Discipling.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's read Colossians. Chapter 4. Verses 5 and 6. This is some final instructions that Paul left with the Colossians whenever he left the Colossians. So, and this is the last part of it. He said, because the first part of this is talking about him praying for him or whatever, but this last part, I believe, is to us just as well as it was to them. It says, be wise in the way you act towards outsiders. Make the most of every opportunity. Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone. Kate, would you read that out of the Amplified?
It says,
I know it's bound to read a whole lot better.
Behave yourselves wisely, living prudently and with discretion in your relations with those of the outside world or the non-Christians, making the very most of the time and seizing or buying up the opportunity. Let your speech at all times be gracious, pleasant, and winsome, seasoned as it were with salt, so that you may never be at a loss to know how you ought to answer anyone who puts a question to you.
Amen. You know, and as I was writing my note last night, and I mean, just this here that I read, but what she read is so much more. And I wrote this down here. I said, that verse says it all. I mean, that verse says, how can you expound on that? What he said is that's what we need to be. We need to be wise. We need to have our conversation flavored with salt, so that when we speak to the outside world, when we speak to sinners, we'll have the things that we should say to them.
Amen.
You know? Amen. But not try to talk their language, but talk the language of God and let them get something out of it.
Amen.
So many times we find ourselves leaning towards talking away, because we don't want to. We don't want to be flaky here, We don't want to come off like we're flaky, So we kind of blend over to them, talk the way they talk instead of the way we should be talking.
Amen.
With our conversation seasoned with salt. Amen. Let's go back to Matthew chapter 5. See, I think I had one other scripture I'm going to read to. Mark chapter 9. Let's see here. Mark chapter 9, verse 15. I'm going to go back to Matthew 5. Says, and this is basically still talking about salt. Salt is good, but if it loses its saltiness, how can you make it salty again? Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with God. And I just wanted to read that. That was kind of Mark's. Basically, that was Mark's going along with Matthew chapter 5 here. But anyway, getting back to the light. Back to the light. We should be light. We should be letting our light shine when we are in the world, when we're in the workplace, when we're in the market, when we're driving down the road.
Yep.
Hello? I believe there's so many of us.
You sure you want to do that when somebody cuts you off?
Right. That's what I'm talking about. or sitting at a red light. I heard Pastor John Hagee tell this story. He's sitting at this red light. And he said he's sitting behind this little old lady in front of him. The light grows green. And he sits there. And the light goes red. And he sits there. And the light goes green. And he sits there. And the light goes red. And he sits there. And the light goes green. He said, he stuck his fist out the window and said, "You better move here, I'm going to move you." And I know y'all know that's how John Hagee, "Y'all better move here, I'm going to move you." And I don't know how he found out about it, but it was a little old lady that was in his church. And there the pastor is out there hollering at the people. But, That's what I'm talking about. That's when your light gets tried, is whenever, you know, because see, and this is what happened to me this week, and this is what I'm talking about, your light shining, and don't let the devil blow it out.
Yeah.
Right. Don't let the devil blow your light out. You see, because he's trying to blow your light out.
Yeah.
Well, see, when somebody cuts you off in traffic, or somebody comes in and you're waiting in line, and you've been waiting in line, not talking about nobody. You've been waiting in line, and she walks up there, and she's got an attitude, and, you know, and going to cut in front of you. And
I let my light shine.
I know. You told me.
I did.
And she, you know, she had the opportunity to let her light shine, or she had the opportunity to let the devil blow it out.
Yeah.
You see, we sing that song, ain't gonna let Satan blow it out, I'm gonna let it shine. But we never realized that that's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
When we're talking about, I ain't gonna let Satan blow it out, that's what we're talking about. He's trying to blow your light out.
Yeah.
But you see, we're indignant Christians, you know, and we're driving down the road and we just got out of church today. How dare you cut me off? You know, you just left church today. And now you're, how dare you? And the devil just went,
yep. Oh my.
He just blowed your light. Come out.
You'd make a good actor, wouldn't
you? Am I telling the truth? Am I telling the truth?
Amen. You're
talking about women in here. I know, I'm trying to give me a little nap. You woke me up.
I got a shout out, man, because he got his sunshine on. I don't know if he's sleeping or not. Sometimes he is. I mean, yeah, that's why he's wearing them silly Ray Charles sunglasses. Yeah.
I don't want to be in the bathroom.
You know, what the Lord showed me was, okay, I'm going to share what happened with me. You know, everybody where I work knows I pastor a church. You know, and I've talked about pastoring a church and all, you know. But I don't look at pastoring a church as a, you know, I'm the pastor of this church. I'm the pastor of this church because I believe God has planted me here. I'm glad to be, but I'm fine. I'd be just as fine driving that truck. I'd be just as fine being a welder. You know, but I want to do what God called me to do. And I don't say I'm the pastor of a church. You know,
highfalutin way.
Yeah, a highfalutin way. Thank you. You can tell how highfalutin I am because I ain't thinking those highfalutin words a lot of times. You know?
You better watch it. She's got a word for everything.
Trying to help.
Thank you. I need it sometimes. But you know, they know I'm a pastor. And so, they know I'm a Christian. And this is what grieved me so much about the way I acted Friday. You know, I talk about I'm a pastor and I talk about I'm a Christian. I'm telling y'all, Friday, I did not like to act like a pastor, and I did not act like a Christian. Some of my fellow workers, and even the man I work for.
You lost your temper.
I lost my temper.
Because you're human, too.
And I let Larry step up here. And when Larry steps up here, Larry stepped forward. Old Seth. Oh, S-E-L-F gets in the front. And let me tell you something, when SELF gets in the front, there ain't no Jesus there.
Right.
And who's the light? Larry ain't. Jesus is the light. And he's the light that should be coming out of me. But when old SELF stands up and he blocks to that lens, that Jesus light comes out of it. It's all about me. I went off on the dispatcher Friday morning because things wasn't going to go the way that I wanted them to go. I said the word about ship in high transit. Ship high in transit. That's what I said. I said it 3 or 4 times. Ship high in transit.
What does that mean?
S-H-I-T.
Don't figure out. I didn't see that.
You see, we're the light. Should have known she'd blur it out. We're on camera, you know. I am. You're behind it.
You did it.
That was her.
He said it.
I don't
she just fell.
Yeah. I didn't do that.
But you see.
Bleep that. We'll edit.
I don't matter. We're real. We're real.
Yeah.
But you see, what I'm trying to get you to see is Larry stepped forward Friday morning, and the light of God, the light of Jesus, could not be seen all day Friday. Larry stepped forward. And he did not let his light shine Friday. And you see, that's where I should be shining my light.
Yeah.
That's where I should be letting the light of Jesus shine. You know, yesterday morning I was coming out of coming from Hod, and I was just south of Winfield, and I was praying and talking to the Lord, and this is where another little bit of this light broke through. The light breaking through. I was praying, and the Lord showed me my whole life. I would let Jesus be out here in front as long as it didn't bother Larry's pride, and it didn't, you know. But there's things about Larry that, you know, Larry's getting out here. It's like Friday morning. It's about Larry now. It ain't about Jesus. You know, it's about me. Instead of putting me behind and acting like the pastor and the Christian that I should be, I got old SELF out here demanding my rights.
I bet you had to apologize to the Lord, didn't you?
Yes, sir. I got to apologize to a few other folks, too. If I'm going to be a true man of God.
Yeah.
And that's what I want to be. I told the Lord, I want to be a Christian on Monday, a Christian on Tuesday, a Christian on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Amen.
I want to be a Christian when I'm driving down the road. I want to be a Christian when I get out and go into that plant out at West Baco, or wherever I go. But I go into all kinds of plants and all. I'm telling you, it's going to take some adjusting. Yes, I pastored here. And like you said, Janie, I am human. That's the part of us that we've got to put down.
Yeah.
That's the part of us that we've got to put in the back. That's the part of us that cannot come forward.
That's right.
If we're going to let Jesus come forward. And it's hard to do. But the more you do it, the easier it'll get.
Amen.
And it's not undoable.
That's right.
You can do it. You can let the light of Jesus shine in you everywhere you go. But it's a matter of being real, and it's a matter of not living phony, and it's a matter of not blending. What I was talking about, it says nobody puts a lights a lamp and puts a bowl over it. Well, that's one thing. But then talking about Satan blowing your light out, and this is what the Lord showed me. You're out there in the world. Think about this. Say your headlights on your vehicle, and you end up driving down a muddy, dirty road and all, and the mud gets all over your lights and all, and pretty soon you can't hardly see because the mud's got your lights where you can't see. Mm-hmm. We're going through this muddy world, and the devil's slinging mud everywhere. Well, you see, if you ain't got the shield out there keeping that mud from getting on what your light is shining through, then he's slinging mud up there. See, he slung mud at me Friday, and I let it stick to my lens. It's darkened. It's hindered my light to be able to shine where I work. Do you see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
That's what it's talking about when he said, ain't going to let Satan blow my light out. That's exactly what it's talking about. He darkens your light. He sees you being a light. Where are you working? Where are you working? Where are you working? Where are you driving down the road with friends? He sees you being a light there. And he goes to trying to sling mud on the lenses to get that light, to dim that light. He don't want you shining your light. He's trying to make your light not be able to shine. And see, the one thing he can do is he can get OSELF out there, and OSELF will give him whatever he wants. Because I got rocks. Quiet this morning.
A lot to think about.
It's good preaching.
Yeah.
I'm preaching to myself, folks.
Where you see that?
Huh?
Where you see that?
Because of what happened to me. This is where this message originated from with me.
Well, it means you're a good preacher.
Well, that's what happens a lot of times. He gets on to me. I get on to you.
You did that. I keep you on me. I keep my mouth shut. You're a good preacher.
He didn't want to help you. He's going to jump on you anyway.
1 Peter 5:8. Everybody knows what 1 Peter 5:8 says, don't you? We've been preaching out of it the last 2 or 3 weeks. First Peter 5:8 says, be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith. That's what I've been talking about, is that verse right there. You know, we preach it a lot of times about him trying to put sickness on us, about him trying to take our finances, and that's fine and good. But also, in this case, he's roaming around as a roaring lion. He's roaming around trying to find some way to sling mud on your light lens and get your lights dirty. Because, you see, if he can keep you from shining the light to others, he don't care how rich you are, he don't care how healthy you are, as long as you don't shine the light so that old so-and-so out there gets saved and filled with the Holy Ghost and starts preaching.
Yeah.
Because when he gets saved and he gets filled with the Holy Ghost and he starts preaching, now you got two of them to deal with.
Yeah.
See?
Amen.
So now he got not only got to try to darken your light, he got to try to darken your light.
Yeah.
But then she preaches to so-and-so over here, and he gets saved, filled with the Holy Ghost. Now you got three to deal with, you see?
Yeah. Yeah.
So he's trying to keep our light from shining. That's his ultimate goal.
Yeah.
Is to try to keep our light from shining. Because why? Because Jesus is the light of the world. And Jesus' light shines only through us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now wait a minute, brother. He can shine his light any way he wants to, and he chooses to shine it through us.
That's right.
That's how his light shines. That's why he said, you are the light of the world.
Yeah, right.
The light has been lit in you. Don't let Satan blow it out. Don't put a cover over it and keep it covered up.
Amen.
Set it on a heap. And let it drive the cockroaches out.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God.